Hello guys, welcome to the new video series of OOPS concepts for interview. When you are preparing for any kind of technical interview, then OOPS is the most important thing you should prepare. Because the most of the part, like 60-70% of your interview will based on your OOPS concept. So this is most important and the most essential part of your interview. So you should be sure about OOPS concept. So in the whole video series, I will cover all the questions regarding to OOPS concept. And after completing the whole video series, you will be able to answer any kind of question which is asked by interviewer from the topic of OOPS. So basically, interviewer asks the questions, or he will start asking the question from OOPS like this. That tell me something about OOPS, what do you know about OOPS, and can you tell me something about OOPS, and what do you understand by OOPS. So this kind of question you may find when you start your interview. After providing the answer that OOPS are this, when you provide the definition of OOPS or the some properties of OOPS, they will ask the question from these properties. So basically the first question may be like this, that please tell me about OOPS concept, or can you explain what is OOPS concept. So the first question may be like this. After that you will explain what is OOPS. So I will cover the all regarding questions which is related to OOPS. After that I will also share some interview experience of a good companies. I will share my own experiences as well as my colleague experiences. So you will be able to answer any kind of question from your interview. So in this video series, I will cover all the concepts of OOPS. So I will cover first of all, I will cover all the general concept of OOPS. After that, I will cover some concept which is related to C++ and related to Java. So I will cover all the concepts. So if you complete the whole video series of OOPS concept, then you can answer any kind of question of your interviewer in interview. So for more detail, you can go download C++ programming solution Android app, which contains all the placement regarding stuff like how to prepare for written exam, how to prepare for your aptitude exam, how to prepare for your technical interview, how to prepare for your HR or managerial technical interview. So you will get all the details in C++ programming solution. So you can download it, and you can also provide the rating for it. Previously you have provided a very good rating. So thank you for that, and you can download it and you can prepare for your interview. So let's come to our main topic. So I will cover all the concept and all the questions regarding to OOPS in small videos. So it will be a complete series. So when you will complete the whole series of OOPS concept for interview, so you will be able to answer any kind of question. So let's begin with OOPS concepts. So the first question, what do you know about the OOPS? So you can say that OOPS have the following properties, and you will name them like encapsulation. So they are mainly polymorphism. So polymorphism, let's say P denote polymorphism. After that, inheritance, I do not inheritance, and encapsulation and abstraction. So basically these are the four important properties of OOPS. So first of all, when they will ask the question that can you tell me something about OOPS concept, so you should start with like this, that OOPS has some property like polymorphism, inheritance, encapsulation and abstraction. After that, you can continue with the definition of this concept, or they will ask you like what do you mean by polymorphism, or what is the difference between encapsulation and abstraction. So I will cover each of them one by one in upcoming video, but this is the introductory video where I am going to give you the overview of object oriented programming language. So basically there are main four properties. It also have some extra properties we will discuss in later videos, but when they ask tell me something about OOPS concept or object oriented programming, then you should mention these four compulsorily. That means you have to explain these four. If you will explain all of these all of these with their definitions, then it will be good for you. So you should explain like this, that polymorphism. The polymorphism allow us to define the more than one function with the same name. After that, inheritance, we can inherit the property of base class into class, child class. After that, encapsulation, define the, we can wrap the data member and member function into a single unit, and this unit is known as class. So no one from outside can modify the data. And abstraction is a, showing the functionality and hiding the complexity. So you can simply, briefly explain the definition of all these four properties. After that, they will ask the question from any one of them. Then you have to answer each of them. So I will discuss all the questions which can be asked with the polymorphism, with the inheritance, and with the encapsulation, as well as from the abstraction. And I will explain each of them one by one. So first of all, you should explain these things. So this is the introductory video where I just want to tell you that what we will cover in this course. So I will cover all these concepts of OOPs. These are the general concept which is same for all programming language. All programming language will, these are same, but when we come to inheritance, like if we come in inheritance, so there are multiple kind of inheritance which will be different programming, but the main idea will be same for all programming language. So these are the common area. So I will cover all these things, and you should understand what is the meaning of each of the property of object oriented programming. After that, I will also cover some concepts like what are the exception handling. Because it actually exception handling and OOPs are the different things, but these are interrelated to each other. When we are talking about the program, we support object oriented program, they also support the exception handling. So I will also cover some exception handling, and I will also cover some concepts that where we use the where we can achieve the abstraction in different programming, like how we achieve the encapsulation or the abstraction in C++ or in Java. So I will explain all of them one by one. So basically, first of all, I will cover these four properties, which are the basic properties of object-oriented programming. So this is a, these are the common for all programming language. After that, I will cover the properties inside them. Inside them, that means how we can achieve a polymorphism with the help of example. Because when you are facing the interview, they will ask some definition. Like some companies ask like only the definition. Some companies say that okay, please write the program how we can achieve the polymorphism or how we can achieve the inheritance. So we have to write a program, a pseudo code or a simple logic for finding the polymorphism or inheritance or encapsulation or abstraction. So I will explain one by one each of them with the help of their example. So if you like the video, please do like. If, don't forget to subscribe channel. And after completing the whole series of OOPs concept of interview, you will be able to answer any kind of question from these concepts, as well as other concepts which are like exception handling, what is the meaning of abstract class and encapsulation and interface, and what is the multi-level inheritance, multiple inheritance. So there are various questions inside these concepts. So we will discuss one by one in small like 5 to 10 minute videos, and after completing the whole course, you will be able to answer any kind of question for any kind of company, and you will get a place in a good company. Because when you are going for interview, when you are going to interview, then 70% of your interview, it depends on your OOPs concepts, and the 30% of your interview depends on your problem solving skill, like how you can solve the problem. So most part of your interview will concentrated on the object oriented programming concepts. So you should learn, you should invest most time, most of your time for preparing for OOPs concept. So that's why I am starting the series. If you like the video, please do like, and don't forget to subscribe. And you can also download C++ programming solution Android app, which contains all these concept with their video explanation, as well as other placement regarding like programming concept, how to crack the written your written programming test. So you can also download the C++ programming solution for better understanding. So this was the introductory video of OOPS concept, that how to start with OOPS concept. In next upcoming video, we will discuss in a quick way to cover all these things. So I think that's it for today. Thank you for watching.